Hi, I am Sasha. I'm glad to see you on my channel, and today we get studying the structure of the cell and their function. To begin with, all living organisms are made up of cells. So the cell is the main functional and structural unit of the living. The term cell was suggested by Robert Hooke. He saw the cell of tree bark within a microscope, and they reminded him of monk cells. So that is the way the cell got its name. You know that there are such kingdoms of living organisms: plants, animals, fungi, and bacteria. Their cells differ in their kinds and functions, but they have a common plan for the structure. There are also viruses, but they don't consist of the cells, so we are not going to talk about them today. Any cells consist of an external membrane or plasma lemma, organelles, and inclusions. The cell membrane or plasma lemma surrounds the cell and holds all the organelles. It consists of two layers of phospholipids and proteins. It's located between the environment and internal space of the cell. So substances are transported through a membrane. Membrane does not let any substances into the cell, so it regulates what should get into it and what should not. Another plasma lemma contains receptors, so it can react to stimuli. Some organisms have an additional membrane above the cell membrane. It is called the cell wall. Plants have it from cellulose, fungi have the one from chitin, and bacteria are from murine. The internal space of the cell is called the cytoplasm. Cytoplasm contains nucleus, organelles, and inclusions. The nucleus is an organelle found in eukaryotic cells. It contains the majority of the cell's genetic material and storage of proteins and RNA in the nucleolus. Prokaryotic cells don't have a nucleus. Their genes are in the nucleoid. Constant components of the cell that perform certain function in them are called organelles. Organelles can be B-membrane, single membrane, and non-membrane. Mitochondria and plastids are two membrane organelles. Mitochondria produce ATP energy for a cell, so they are called cell power stations. Chloroplasts are plant organelles. Chloroplasts contain thylakoids on which photosynthesis occurs. Photosynthesis is a process of formation of organic compounds from carbon dioxide and water. Now, let's consider single membrane organelles. Single membrane organelles includes vacuoles, the Golgi complex, the endoplasmatic reticulum, and lysosomes. The endoplasmatic reticulum forms a wall labyrinth of membranes within the cell. So, it separates the components of the cell and allows the different chemical reaction to pass in different parts of the cell. If there are ribosomes on APR membranes, then it is called RAUF, and proteins are formed on it. There are no ribosomes on smooth APR. Look at the lysosome. They look like small bubbles. They perform the function of digestion in a cell and contain enzymes. Vacuoles are cavities within a cytoplasm. In plants, they are filled with cell sap and maintain pressure. In the simplest, they can be digestive and contractile. The contractile vacuoles remove excess water from a cell and maintain internal pressure. This is very important because the concentration of cells in the water can change, which can lead to an increase in the pressure inside the cell. To prevent this, such vacuoles constantly shrink and squeeze out extra moisture. The Golgi complex is similar to the Wi-Fi icon, do you agree? It consists of tubules, tubes, and vesicles. This organelle packs and carries the substances formed in the cell. And it can also form vacuoles or lysosome from one of its vesicles. Also, there are non-membrane organelles, ribosomes and centrosomes. The ribosome consists of two cells that together resemble a snowman. These cells are composed of protein and RNA. The function of ribosome is formation of proteins. The centrosome consists of two cylinders from the protein tubulin. The main function of centrosome is participation in cell division and formation of the cytoskeleton. Today we got acquainted with the structure of the cell as well as with its functions. If you like the video, then subscribe our project with good and nice comment. You can also subscribe to the channel and click the bell to not skip new videos. Enjoy your time!